Good day friends, today we will see about HbA1c. The content of the video include the terminology, description, principle, sample preparation, advantage and disadvantage, normal and abnormal value of HbA1c. HbA1c, one of the common investigation done for diabetes. Few terminologies are important for better understanding of HbA1c. First is Hb, otherwise called hemoglobin. HbA1c is a glycated variant of hemoglobin. We have two terminology called glycosylation and glycation. Glycosylation is addition of sugar moiety to the protein molecule. Glycosylation is once sugar is attached to the RBC, it can't be removed from the RBC for its entire lifespan, which is 120 days. For that, first we'll understand life cycle of RBC. So whenever RBC is produced from bone marrow, it is circulated through this blood vessel. After its period, it is destroyed by the spleen. During that entire duration, the glucose moiety is attached to the hemoglobin. The test is limited to 3 months average because the lifespan of red blood cells is 120 days. What does the HbA1c test measure? When the blood sugar is higher, the more sugar is attached to the hemoglobin. So there is higher percentage of HbA1c. This is given as percentage. Why HbA1c is important? It is always important to know HbA1c because higher the level, the chance of diabetic related complications are higher. If the results is lower than the normal, then the chance of developing diabetic related complication are lesser. First we will see the reference value of HbA1c. The normal level include 4.5 to 5.6. Pre-diabetic less than 6.4. Diabetic more than 6.5. Adequate control less than 7. Inadequate control 7 to 8. More than 9 indicate poor control as per American Diabetic Association criteria. How blood sample is collected? The blood sample is collected using a vacuum device with the EDTA. It is usually stable for 7 days at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, whereas stable for 3 days at room temperature. What are the advantages of HbA1c? It is used to look longer control of diabetes, around 3 months. It can be done at any day of time. It is not influenced by diet, exercise or emotional disturbance on that particular test day. It is used as an index for a clinical trial. It can be useful if you miss the drug or default diet. It can also be used to identify stress-induced hyperglycemia. Apart from above said advantage, there are few more advantages with HbA1c. First is, fasting sample is not required for HbA1c. The inter-individual variability is less than 2%. HbA1c sample is stable, but the blood sugar level can be variable according to the reagent. HbA1c value is not altered by acute factor which is affecting the blood sugar values. HbA1c is a better index for predicting complication rather than fasting and postprandial blood sugar value. The limitation of HbA1c. HbA1c can't be used in an emergency room to titrate oral hypoglycemic drug or insulin. HbA1c can't be used to register hypoglycemia. It is not so sensitive in patients with anemia, uremia, and pregnancy. Factors affecting HbA1c level: acute hyperglycemia, severe anemia, gestational diabetes, lifespan of RBC, abnormal hemoglobin types, and method of estimation. There are different causes for high and low HbA1c level. High HbA1c level include newly diagnosed diabetes, uncontrolled diabetes, non-diabetic hyperglycemia, particularly obesity, acromegaly and Cushing syndrome, post-splenectomy and alcoholic patient. There are few causes for low HbA1c level, which include chronic blood loss, chronic renal failure, hemolytic anemia. Apart from above said causes, there might be inappropriate level of HbA1c. How to calculate mean plasma glucose level? Mean plasma glucose usually calculated based on a formula using 33.3 into HbA1c level minus 86. It can give approximate sugar value according to HbA1c level. What is the correlation with HbA1c and disease? When you reduce HbA1c by 1%, the death related to diabetes is down by 21%, microvascular complication down by 27%, myocardial infarction down by 14%. HbA1c directly correlate with diabetic related complication. HbA1c directly correlate with diabetic retinopathy. There is a strong correlation with the HbA1c level and diabetic retinopathy. In this chart, you can see HbA1c has a direct correlation with diabetic retinopathy, diabetic nephropathy, diabetic neuropathy, and microalbuminuria. So there is an age-specific target for HbA1c less than 6 years, less than 8.5, 6 to 12 years, less than 8, 13 to 19 years, less than 7.5. Good diabetic control leads to less complication in the future. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box. Thank you. There are different causes for high and low HbA1c level. High HbA1c level include newly diagnosed diabetes, uncontrolled diabetes, non-diabetic hyperglycemia, particularly obesity, acromegaly and Cushing syndrome, post-splenectomy and alcoholic patient. There are few causes for low HbA1c level, which include chronic blood loss, chronic renal failure, hemolytic anemia. Apart from above said causes, there might be inappropriate level of HbA1c. How to calculate mean plasma glucose level? Mean plasma glucose usually calculated based on a formula using 33.3 into HbA1c level minus 86. It can give approximate sugar value according to HbA1c level. What is the correlation with HbA1c and disease? When you reduce HbA1c by 1%, the death related to diabetes is down by 21%, microvascular complication down by 27%, myocardial infarction down by 14%. HbA1c used for a diabetic related complication. HbA1c directly correlate with diabetic related complication. HbA1c directly correlate with diabetic retinopathy. There is a strong correlation with the HbA1c level and diabetic retinopathy. In this chart, you can see HbA1c has a direct correlation with diabetic retinopathy, diabetic nephropathy, diabetic neuropathy, and microalbuminuria. So there is an age-specific target for HbA1c, less than 6 years, less than 8.5, 6 to 12 years, less than 8, 13 to 19 years, less than 7.5. Good diabetic control leads to less complication in the future. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box. Thank you.